Hello and welcome to On the Fly. I am Keith Irizarry. On Pi Day, there were many sweet storylines as 24 teams took to the ice. Braden was certainly on point. Were the Red Wings clipped for a seventh straight game? Buffalo looked to make it three wins in a row. We had a shootout in Columbus, and the Leafs tried to impose their will on the Flyers. But we begin in Carolina with what could be an Eastern Conference final preview. The Panthers, the Canes. Here's your heavyweight highlights.
Brent Burns was going to leave it there for Natchez, and Natchez went away. Now a turnover. Panthers coming up with it. Nick Cousins into the corner. Quick little shot that danced along the goal line, and Anderson makes the save.
It almost went off of Anderson and in.
Now it's a power play opportunity for the Florida Panthers. It comes out in front of Anderson, robbing Verhaeghe. On a broken play, Verhaeghe got loose. And the Canes settle this one down. Now a stretch pass for Staal. Staal has it knocked off his stick. Jarvis shoots, he scores! Bobrovsky didn't see it. High to the glove. 1-0. Seth Jarvis in the cage.
What a stretch pass up the ice. Late in the period from Jacob Slavin to the captain. Gorgeous release, going backhand, forehand, high to the glove.
Ball on the boards, Chatfield will flutter one, bounces, Kuznetsov, Getzel, still bouncing, Kuznetsov, Getzel gets past him. Haynes keeping it, low shot, Orlov, save Bobrovsky, Natchez from an impossible shot angle, beats Bobrovsky, and it's 2-0 Carolina.
I loved everything about that.
I've heard of a diving catch, that's the first time I've seen a diving shot with that much zip on it. To the far post for Marty Natchez. Natchez steps in on the play. Chatfield, he'll get it across. Kuznetsov works and scores! Oh, take flight and Getty! 3-0 Carolina!
I have dreaded those Kuznetsov wings in Raleigh for years. And now, I'm like a kid in a candy store seeing them.
Drop back to Natchez. Natchez out in front! And Getzel just a hair away from his first! Oh, hit the post and stayed. Matthew Tkachuk trying to get it going with Aho. Well, we just got to get used to this. Every whistle near the netminder. Right on, Bobrovsky will make the save. And now Jalen Chatfield getting involved out in front. Staal is there.
Who came in defense of Natchez? In comes Kuznetsov, and he's telling Natchez, hey, keep your wits about you. Getzel's right there, too. You love to see that.
And Karavainen. Canes will get busy. This one in a bouncing puck. Florida's not ready for it, and he scores! Oh, my! Andrei Svechnikov, just like you draw it up. Chatfield with it, takes it to his own zone, and Carolina has taken the regular season series. Frederik Andersen, his first shutout of the season.
Yeah, we got a bad game last game, and it was a big game for us, so we lost the division opponent team. So for us was the special atmosphere tonight. We knew that Florida is a big team, probably the toughest in our division, or in our conference, wherever. So, you know, we just give everything we had tonight. 2 points tonight, team points, that's big. That's number one for us, team ahead of the everything. We don't care who scores, who makes assist. We just get a W and prepare ourselves for the big game next.
That was certainly some fun, and sometimes it takes a few games to get used to a new team, new city, new fans, but the newcomers for the Canes finally got through against the Panthers. Kuznetsov and Getzel recorded their first points with the club while skating over 17 minutes on the ice. And we welcome in our guy, Mike Kelly, to break this one down. Mike, you're looking great as always. And recently, Florida looked like one of the best teams in the NHL. Tonight, the Canes and their trade deadline acquisitions handled them, dare I say, easily. So what did we learn from this one? And do you believe that this could end up being a preview of the East Final?
Oh, it very well could, and I hope it will be, because this would be a nasty series. Look, what you need to know about these two teams, they're mirror images of each other in a lot of different ways. They dump pucks out, they dump pucks in, they battle, they force turnovers. They don't allow anything. They shoot a ton of pucks at the net. So the heavy team, the hardworking team, is going to win. And if you look at this game, Carolina won almost 80% of the puck battles. They created three times as many scoring chances by forcing turnovers, tripled Florida in slot shots, won the game, as you said, kind of easily in that sense. It's heavy hockey. And you look at Jordan Staal, pressure right here. Oh, forces a quick pass, lots of turnover. And there's Jordan Staal again with the puck. And in comes Carolina, and they got their first goal of the game. Both of these teams are so good. In fact, they're the best two teams in the league at forcing turnovers. It's a lot of pressure from both of them. And Carolina just had it a little bit better in this game. Here's Jake Guentzel, noted forechecker Jake Guentzel going in, forcing a bad reverse. Now you get the puck back. Kuznetsov with the patience, and he scores. The Kuznetsov line was fantastic. Jordan Staal's line was unbelievable in this game. And we saw the nastiness in the highlights. These teams just want to kill each other. So, again, like I said, elite teams, images of each other in terms of the puck management value that they have. And I hope we get to see them play in the playoffs, because it is going to be a gnarly series if they do.
Post-trade deadline, I am looking at this East and I am saying, this is absolutely loaded. Well, we have an original six rivalry on tap next, the Bruins and the Canadiens in Montreal.
Chasing after it is Pastrnak. Leads the NHL in shots on goal. 88, always dangerous. Carlo in front on a tip. Rebound, and that hit the crossbar. Monza Boats has it early. Cruising across with Zacha. The screen in front, the deflection, and it stayed out.
Pastrnak to Zacha. To Pastrnak! And Heinen scores! Danton Heinen didn't give up on the play.
What second effort, concentration and awareness by Dan Heinen, falling backwards away from the net and at a somewhat challenging angle, still able to slide it in.
Gouley able to get back and close him off. Steal by Zacha. Zacha, Pastrnak, in, across, Gouley saves it. Caden Gouley picked that off in time. Suzuki, the backhand in. In comes Caulfield. He'll check Carlo. Caulfield trying to get to the puck. Shoves Carlo down. Suzuki shot. Slafkovský, Suzuki score! Beautiful little passing play. Slafkovský to Suzuki. And that is 26 on the season. Ties his career high. We're tied up at one.
Nice heads-up play by Slafkovský to turn around and find his centerman there for the goal to tie it up.
New hook. Tripped in traffic. Gets a gift. Armia stoned by Omar.
Best off for Linus Allmark of the game, in tight off the turnover.
Caulfield, good control, but gives it away. Zacha sends Pastrnak forward, and Pastrnak off the apron, wide of the post. What a turn of events. We go to the third, tied 1-1.
Rizzo, Zacha up top. Geeky hands it off. Zacha shoots. Rizzo's out of the net. Left pass stop.
The Bruins can't get it done with the man advantage.
And the series finale will go to overtime. Lindholm touches it to Marchand. He breaks with DeBrusque. DeBrusque scores! Jake DeBrusque wins it at 25 seconds of the overtime. 2-1 Bruins.
I'll tell you, Jake DeBrusque had a real strong game tonight. Rewarded for it here in OT with the winner.
Yep, the Bruins and the Habs needed extras to settle this long-time rivalry, and it was DeBrusque and his 16th goal of the season to win it for the Bees, but it was Brad Marchand who set him up, grabbing his 26th point in overtime in his career and passing former captain and line mate Patrice Bergeron for the most in franchise history.
And he has stepped in, done a nice shot. His Stamkos shooter. By Igor Shesterkin. 2-on-1 developing. Panarin drag. The shot. Oh, Trocheck sets up Panarin for a beauty. And the great finish by Artemi Panarin. In deep to Banachan. In front. Braden Schneider off a brilliant feed from Mika Zibanejad. It's 2-0 Rangers. Jack Roslovic's first point as a New York Ranger. Outstanding first period for the Rangers. Chernak takes it. Zibanejad blocks it.
puck went up and got
him. Yeah, got him. He's shaking up on the play.
As Zibanejad goes to the Rangers locker room.
Rodzinski turns it over. Here's Point with Kucherov. Back to Point. And his goal!
You break Igor Shesterkin's shutout string.
Brandon Point gets the Lightning on the board.
Now Duclair. Open net.
Saw Zibanejad get hit, and he's wearing a bubble right now. Looked like he might have got a couple of stitches.
Here's Fox. Good pass. Score! Jack Roslovic, his first goal as a New York Ranger.
For Tanner Mott, his shot off the stick of Gustafson. Now there's a collision in front of the net. Was that Dumba who bumped into Shesterkin? And that is going to cause all kinds of commotion.
Teams are skating four aside.
Here's Hedman, across, Point in, and he scores! Brandon Point, what a goal! Tie game again!
Sorelli with a shot blocked. Whoa! Lafreniere with a block, and he gets up very slowly.
Not had a lot of power play time tonight, but this one, you're right, is crucial. Digs it out, gets it to Sorelli. Here's Point, back to Stamkos! Point game, including a hat trick. Second consecutive game, the Lightning have had a guy put up five, and John Cooper is once again chatting with one of the most clutch guys he's ever coached, I'm sure. Net is empty for the Rangers. Here's Kucherov. Yes, sir. Empty net goal for Kucherov, and it is final. John Cooper and the Lightning bank two very valuable points against the New York Rangers. Led by Braden Point, who ties a franchise record with 6 points tonight.
I think it was just competing. I think, definitely in the first period and into that second period, we were a little slow, not making the best plays, a lot of turnovers. And I think we kind of found our legs in the second and competed in the third, and the result was great for us.
I think they took it a little personal, you know, the first period, and they got a great mindset being able to bounce back and, Point or 6 points. I think Cooch had five. I mean, two of the top players in the world for a reason. They showed it tonight. These are huge games, and you need your best players to be your best players, and they certainly were tonight.
The Stars showed up in Tampa as the Lightning hand it to the Blue Shirts. Braden Point, he was the main highlight, right? Recording his third hat trick of the season. Three assists on the way as well. Becomes just the third Lightning player with a 6-point game. And look who else is there. Nikita Kucherov, who had 5 points in the game, did it earlier this season as well. Bring Mike back in, and the Rangers, hey, listen, they led early, looked like they were, you know, back to their winning ways, and then the game was kind of turned on its head in the second. What happened to turn the tide for Tampa?
Well, I mean, Braden Point, obviously, we'll get to him in a second, but John Cooper as well. We know what a great coach John Cooper is. One of his greatest strengths is making in-game adjustments. We've seen it in the playoffs over the years many, many times. He's always got his finger on the pulse of the team, it seems, to make the right move at the right time. And he made a move midway through the second with Tampa down 2-0, taking Brandon Hagel off that Kucherov and Point line and putting Duclair on it. You look at the numbers with Hagel, the team was outshot 4-0, they were outscored 2-0, and you look at it completely flip when Anthony Duclair joined that line for the second half of this game. 7-1 were the shots, 5-0 from the house, and 3-0 were the goals. It gave a boost of energy to that line, and Braden Point took over. This play here was unbelievable. Neutral zone, takeaway. That gets things started. That was the first shift that Duclair had with these guys, and they just kept on scoring, and they got going on the power play. It all just clicked for the Tampa Bay Lightning after that. Braden Point, 6 points in the game. Kucherov with five. These guys were unbelievable, willing Tampa Bay back to a victory. And like Stamkos said, two of the best players in the world, and they absolutely showed it in this game. So I don't know if you know the movie Gangs in New York. You know about the 5 points in New York?
Yeah.
Well, Tampa Bay's got the 6 points with Braden. So give this man an Oscar for best athlete in a leading role. He was incredible tonight.
And I was going to say something about, like, the Duke of Hazzard. You know, that was the change between the periods, something like that. All right. Hey, Mike, don't look now, but the Sabres, they are in playoff conversation, and a buzzing offense, a hot netminder might actually get it done. Highlights from Buffalo when we come back.
Engvall finds an open lead. Lead for Pageau, and getting a stick on that. At the last moment was Clifton.
Klein gets it back again. High slot. Clutterbuck shot. Stop to the rebound. Oh, Lukanen's got it. Martin took three whacks at it. And that's going to draw some emotion into this game early.
Doesn't do a very good job of taking Lukanen's eyes away. Lukanen's able to make the save.
And now the Sabres the other way from Turkus. Zekas got knocked into by Skinner. Leads to a 2-on-1. And Sorokin got across in the full split on Peyton Krebs.
Boy, oh boy, Zekas got totally interfered with. They missed it. But what a save by Sorokin. He snatched that one out of midair.
Only Pellick back. Greenway to the net. Save. Rebound cleared away by Adam Pellick.
Watch how he plays it. 3-on-1. Stays in the middle of the ice. Shoots towards the possible pass and lets the goaltender handle the shooter all the way.
Sabres going to the power play here for the first time.
Islanders pretty spread out there in the middle of the ice. Paterka walks in. Far side. Scores! It squeaks through. Victor Olsson on the power play. Puts Buffalo up 1-0.
Nice pass by Paterka finding Olsson down low. Usually a little bit higher there looking for that one-time shot.
Battle for it along the wall. Skinner comes away with it. Far circle. Shot with a rebound. Comes and scores! Pucks to the net, and then the workhorse from Whitehorse buries it. Sabres 2, Islanders no score.
So Sorokin can't handle it because his goal goes off his pads. Great to kind of Dylan Cousins, and he's able to tap it in.
Clearing attempt by Holmstrom. Power kept it in. Joakim Harju scores! That might have been tipped in front, but Henry let it rip. And the Sabres, my friends, have a 3-0 lead in the second period. Unless there's a challenge. Goaltender interference.
There's really no contact.
After a review of the play, the call on the ice is confirmed. We have a good goal.
Dylan Cousins going the other way. Cousins already has a goal in this one. Bets into Greenway. Sorokin.
Oh my God.
Another sensational save.
That might have been better than the first one on the glove save because he had to go from his left to his right and get his right arm up and had to play the shooter coming down the slot, Brendan.
Johnson. Horvat. Far side. Lukanen. What a save. Special delivery. UPL got over that far post. Keeps it at 3-0. 28 seconds to go in the power play for the Islanders. And Clifton steps in.
Engvall.
And the gloves are down. It's Palmieri against Connor Clifton. And they're throwing.
I think that might be Lee, Dan.
Is it Lee 27? You are correct. And Connor Clifton.
Clifton just hammered him going down the wall.
Sabres with a chance now to backhand it out. Dahlin lifts it high. Here's a chance. He won't miss this one. Benson scores into the empty net, and it's 4-0 Buffalo. Number 9 scores number 9 on the season.
Complete effort again. Full 60 right from the start. And obviously Upi made some key saves there. Even in the third when it's 3-0. You know, we go shorthanded, and he makes two phenomenal saves. So huge credit to him, and huge credit to all these guys in this room.
We knew how important it was to try and get that first one and just play the right way to start the game and just, you know get the pucks behind him, just try and tire him out, and we'd get our rewards later.
What an absolute machine Ukko-Pekka Luukkonen has turned into, stopping all 21 shots faced against the Islanders for his fifth shutout of the season, trailing just Connor Ingram, Tristan Jarry for the most, and he's the first Sabres goalie since Ryan Miller in the 11-12 campaign with 5 shutouts in a season. Mike is back with us, and listen, the Sabres have now won 3 in a row. They have 69 points. They're 3 points out of a wild card spot. Should we start believing in this team? Do they have chances to make the postseason?
Hey, look, it's Pi Day. I'm a math guy. Technically, everybody's got a chance still. The good news and bad news for Sabres fans. The good news, their odds are a lot better than they were a week ago. The bad news is they're still not great. But look, if you're a fan of the Buffalo Sabres, if you're a player in the room for the Buffalo Sabres. Don't pay any attention to this graphic. A week ago, they were at 1%. Now they're at almost 9. They got a game coming up against the Detroit Red Wings. Detroit can't beat a cold right now. Those odds will go up nicely if they win that game, and they got a big road trip coming up. Do well on the roadie, see where you are when you get back. But the good thing for the Sabres is UPL, like if you haven't been watching Buffalo lately, Ukko-Pekka Luukkonen's been a top five goalie in the league for about 3 months now. He's been fantastic. They're scoring. The young guys are playing well. Fun team to watch. I hope they keep rolling.
So you're saying there's a chance. Yes. Next up, we are heading to Dallas for the Devils and the Stars.
New Devils netminder Jake Allen is getting the nod. He is just swapping the red of Montreal for the black and red in the wild card race. Several teams jumping them now. They know tonight will be a tall task against a top team out in the West.
Puck dropped. We're underway at American Airlines Center. Second and final meeting this season between the Stars and Devils. Wyatt Johnston cuts right down. His shot. He scores! Just seconds into the game. 15 to be exact. A path opens up for Wyatt. He dangles through a herd of Devils.
Trying that extra pass, but you got to continue to try to get things through when the chance is.
Paula forces a turnover, gets the front, he scores!
He cuts the net, and he just roofs it. There's that puck thrown into the middle of the ice. Paula stays patient, and then watch him go backhand, forehand, in tight quarters, and rips it.
I wouldn't doubt if it comes flying in and onto the score sheet. There's a score from the right side, out of nowhere!
They're going to have to open a window. This has a little odor to it if you're Jake Allen.
Clog the middle in their own zone, so got to find a way.
It goes in! Chris Tierney from behind goal! So even up the second Dallas goal, the Devils get a fortunate bounce as well.
Mercer trying to make one of those net front charges that has been his go-to move. Good cycling shift. Mercer's in front. He stops. He shoots. He scores!
And being that creative, crafty guy around the net, and that's exactly what he is here, is he has all kinds of time.
Fan of those kinds of bats. We can go with your America again shortly. Rack the slot. Meyer scores!
This shot is on Timo Meyer's stick and off it in a flash.
And Scott Wedgwood will come off the bench and take over.
Teammate Brett there and comes across and
plenty of time. Nosek scores! His first goal is a Devil and it's 5-2!
Lazar just drops it, they back off. Now it looked like just beat him between the arm and body.
Harley, quick stop, makes a good pass forward, sets up a great opportunity, and Allen says no! He turns away the rebound as well! He stops Johnston first, Pavelski second, and the Devils keep a 5-2 lead.
The Devils couldn't change after that icing.
In the slot, Pavelski, it's blocked by DeSimone. And he blocks it again from 1-knee.
But to have the wherewithal as he blocks the shot in agony, pokes the puck away as the rebound stayed right in front of him. Bill, it's still pretty rewarding.
Fire in the front, oh, and a chance, and Holtz buries it.
Good forecheck by Timo Meyer. Everybody getting involved in the act. Holtz goes upstairs from a pretty sharp angle.
Boxa in late. He shoots. Well, how about one more for Jake Allen?
Yeah.
Closes the five hole for his 35th save of the night.
15 seconds in, do we think we'd be saying this?
And the Devils win 6-2 in Dallas.
It is Timo time. Timo Meyer recorded a goal and one helper on Thursday and has been on fire with 9 goals and 5 assists in his last 10 games. He needs to keep this up if the Devils are going to make a playoff push in the East.
Certainly people will want to talk about this little dust-up of practice between Lucas Raymond and Ben Chiarot yesterday. Under the weight of a 6-game losing streak, guys are going to get frustrated, players and coaches alike.
Yeah, the people are not happy, and they shouldn't be happy. Get angry, get ugly, get mad, go play, and there's going to be a penalty here for Hawking on the chance that Wallman has. Arizona going to be shorthanded.
Flips it along, Logan Cooley with an opportunity, puts it in, Logan Cooley scores! A shorthanded goal! Coyotes with a 1-0 lead.
What a goal by Logan Cooley. That is speed right there. Beautiful pass. And then he just drives it on the backhand, and he finds that possibly 5-hole. That is certainly one that Lyon has got to stop.
Duncan center Rasmussen on a power play coming for Detroit.
That's a break for Detroit that they, again, need to take advantage of.
Kane Raymond, he scores! Lucas Raymond!
Boy, there wasn't much room on that one. That thing was pinpoint right underneath the bar inside the boat. Been a bulldog the last 4 or 5 weeks, Raymond. Competed like crazy. And that was part of the reason he had a dust up with Ben Sherratt in practice yesterday. See, those things can work to your advantage.
Yeah, but McShelly is there. Coyotes keep his own. Now Kerfoot to the point. They score, and it's 2-1. The Coyotes have gotten the lead again.
Started this forecheck, started this cycle, and Kerfoot just gets it to the net, and that goes off of the body of Michael Carcone, who's standing in front, and Lyons still looking for that puck.
That is a big-time goal. Keller on the recovery. Shoots! It's underneath Lyons and almost snuck. Short side by the post.
Clayton Keller, two real good opportunities. Two of the best opportunities of this second period.
Wallman with a shot and blocked by Ingram. No mix up here. Raymond doing what he learned in practice. They're on their feet here. They want something.
All heck is breaking loose in behind the Detroit net.
Sherratt wasn't going to allow that to happen between Brown and Raymond.
Here's the two players on their own team that were kind of dust up yesterday in practice. All is forgiven, and now they've got each other's back. As Keller went down, back for Kane. Good move. In tight. Oh, tried to flip it high under the bar, but the left hand of Ingram saw that coming.
Comes in front. Bukestad is there. He scores. Nick Bukestad. A massive goal here in the third. It's 3-1.
Nick Bukestad high for the safety blanket in case they got to play defense, but he gets a beautiful feed.
Back for Perron. Firing it. Save made. Rebound again. Puck loose. Ahead it goes. Keller for the empty net. And he hits it. The Red Wings will regroup. Still right there with the Islanders losing tonight. So right in the periphery.
And they're blues all year long, Ken.
Yeah.
Not a happy bunch. Nobody's less happy than these guys in red.
That's not acceptable. Obviously, we they come out, they get the first goal. I thought we battled. Obviously, got back that one on the power play. Great play by Kane and Razor there. I mean, it's as tough as it gets right now in the room. We got to find a way to bounce back. We got to find a way to get up and put our pride on the line and be better.
Defensively, I think you see the chances we give up, the breakdowns that we have. When we've been playing well this year, those chances aren't happening as frequently as they are right now. So that's what I see. I see too many chances given up. Puts too much stress on the, you know, what we're trying to do defensively, and it's costing us.
All right, so three words: Yotes, Yikes, Wings. Mike, I'm going to ask it this way: what's happening with these Red Wings?
But kind of a double-edged whammy here. We heard Ben Sherratt talking about the defensive side. That is true. I'm going to talk about the offensive side, because for a long time this season, the Detroit Red Wings have been riding some pretty nice percentages, scoring a lot more than they probably should have been scoring. And more often than not, eventually the regression hockey gods will come for you. Sometimes it's a little bit slow. It's hit the Red Wings all at once. So they're having a real tough time scoring goals right now. That to me is the biggest thing. You look at their last seven games, the seven-game losing streak. Yeah, they're dead last in goals. They're 30th in expected goals. They're kind of somewhat around, I guess, where they could or should be in terms of rankings. But they were only 23rd in expected goals before that, yet they were top five in the league in scoring. Their shooting percentage has basically been cut in half from second best in the league to third worst. So they're getting the regression from way outperforming it offensively to actually now very much underperforming it. That's been a huge part of this thing for the Red Wings, who by and large are kind of just an average team overall.
Yeah, defense is going to win you championships, but you got to score to win games as well. All right, so
yeah.
I promise you, this is not a copy and paste. Auston Matthews has scored again. Highlights of number 55 from number 34 when we return.
Leafs have won seven straight against the Flyers. That's the longest winning streak by either team in the more than 50 years they've been playing against each other. The National Hockey League is a member of the Red Wings. Drops it back, Nylander across the Matthews, shoot, score! Tipped in front by Bertuzzi.
And it's Auston Matthews who's not shooting that puck. He's passing this puck. And there's Bertuzzi beating Mark Stahl, stick down to tap it in back door.
Riley plays it down, chip back in front, they score! Pontus Holmberg fires it home and the Leafs lead 2-0.
Holmberg takes a puck that is rolling off a skate and is able to sling it up quickly.
Not long after, scored his first NHL goal against the Leafs. Here's Konecny, looks back in front, great chance! Rolled wide by Anderson, first stop there by Samsonov. Now Bertuzzi. Back across to Lundgren, walking in, shoots, scores!
What?
Lundgren with a long-distance shot that beats Ericsson, and the Leafs do have a 3-0 lead.
Philly off the power play for Tippett. One time pass, is shot, stop, and a score! Owen Tippett off the carom, off the end boards! This puck gets a good bounce off the boards. Tippett's ready for it. And that's a huge power play goal.
Lyubushkin.
Spinarama, Nylander, high slot, tip, and a save and another stop! Oh, Felix Sandstrom with a couple of dandies!
Matthews banks it ahead and falling awkward is Yarncrook, and he's down. Kelly Yarncrook, off balance, falls into the boards and is having trouble getting up.
Head down the tunnel and get checked out.
No out of bounds in this sport. Lyubushkin back with it. Out to center ice to Holmberg. Holmberg to Matthews, busting in. Austin Matthews shoots, scores! Austin Matthews, just like that, the Leafs are back up by three.
Handles it, hits Matthews in full flight. Austin Matthews likes scoring goals against Philadelphia. Heavy on the ice, just right through, and he understands that was a full five-man sequence.
His 40th even-strength goal of the year.
Drop down to 40th, and another score! Right back the Leafs! Now it's William Nylander, 8 seconds later.
Picked out, centering pass for Domi. Sandstrom makes the stop on him, a sweet feed by Nye. Sandstrom still
behind him. Oh, there it is.
Domi drops it back. Lyubushkin. That hit Eric Johnson. And now Lyubushkin, that's blocked.
It's a yard sale.
Two Flyers don't have sticks. Three Flyers don't have sticks now. Lyubushkin sends it across. Tap back in front. They score. Nice. Taps it home. The Flyers were completely out of options. The Leafs have now won 8 straight against Philadelphia. The longest streak by either team in this long-standing rivalry.
Yeah, so some breaking news, Mike. Auston Matthews is really good at the sport of hockey. All right, now that we have that out of the way, a couple of days off for the Leafs, and this was a dominating performance. What did they do that was so effective against Philadelphia?
Yeah, look, they looked fresh. Matthews was great. Tyler Bertuzzi keeps rolling. They had a lot of guys going in this game. They just overwhelmed the Philadelphia Flyers. And the one thing I want to focus on, though, was kind of a weird game for Philly, just all the bad luck they had, not that they should have won anyways. That was a knuckle puck from Lilligren that found its way in the back of the net. You know, now you got Garnet Hathaway with a skate blade that's off, so he's got the Bambi legs going out there on the penalty kill, just trying to stay on his feet and get into shooting lanes. And this is the weirdest thing I've ever seen. There's three Flyers, and none of them have a stick, trying to defend the Toronto Maple Leafs. It was a bizarre, crazy sequence. So just one of those nights for Philly where absolutely nothing went wrong. The Leafs looked really good. They end up getting the win.
Yeah, that looked like a defensive drill that you should never try to do ever. All right, yeah. Up next, we're going to head to Minnesota. We've got Ducks. We've got Wild.
Murat Husnadinov will make his NHL debut. He's a tremendous talent. I can't wait to see what he can bring to the table.
Frank reverses it around, and Zellweger ran into some resistance. Boldy took it away, and what a save by Dostal on Hartman, who tried to hook it around him after skating across the top of the crease.
Zuccarello for Brodin. He's able to duck past to check. In behind for Rossi. Out to the line. Bogosian, a shot. He scores! Zach Bogosian getting the puck on net.
By the time Dostal picks that puck up after it goes by the Duck winger, it's too late. It's already by him. And the Wild once again in a big goal 15 minutes into this first period.
Lacombe across to Fowler. There's a chance driving in, and a kick save by Fleury denies Leason. The Wild start back with Boldy. He gives to Hartman. Hartman centers. They score! Kaprizov with the deflection. The hottest goal scorer of the NHL strikes again. It's 2-0.
1-0 Minnesota.
Well, how many times have you seen this in the National Hockey League where you get a goal in one end, but 10 seconds before you get a save like that at the other end, and then Ryan Hartman with a nasty little saucer pass to hit Kirill Kaprizov for the slam dunk.
Matt Zuccarello gets it across, Kaprizov again, and this time he's stopped by Lucas Dostal.
Look at the movement now, Bogosian joins and finds Kaprizov, great save Dostal as he read that one nicely moving to his left. With Enda through the neutral zone, joined by Groove. Groove brings it right into the goal crease, ran into Fleury, hacking away at the rebound, Ross Johnston and Regenda, and Pavel Regenda makes it 2-1.
Smash mouth hockey, this is Bo Groove saying, you know what, I'm coming along the goal line and I'm just going to jam it into the crease.
Minnesota is challenging the play for offside.
Oh, they're challenging it for offside.
This is the play right here.
Oh, it's offside, not even close.
It was determined that play was offside prior to the goal.
So they take the goal off the board.
The Wild will improve to 5-0-1 in their last six. And with this victory, the Wild are back within 4 points of the final playoff spot in the West. It's a 2-0 shutout for Marc-Andre Fleury.
The Wild have now won 5 of their last 6 games, and really most in due part to their superstar. Kirill Kaprizov extended his point streak to 6 games, where he's tallied 8 goals and 3 assists and is a plus 6 on the ice.
And that is about as poor a first 3-plus minutes as the Penguins have played this season. Looking for some momentum. Scores! Carlson let it go! And the Penguins get the much-needed first goal tonight.
Thron, far side, Jarry the save! Zetterlund scores on the rebound! Fabian Zetterlund, and it's 1-1. Vlasic now, from the angle, he scores! And the Sharks have the lead.
Addison behind his own net. Taken away by Bemstrom. Carter scores! The Penguins take advantage. O'Connor, poor Malkin over the line. Flips it back to O'Connor. Save, Crota, rebound, score! Evgeny Malkin slams it home. And the Penguins go back in front 3-2.
Gets it away from Joseph. Trying to hit Granlund cutting through the middle. Vlasic to the net. Granlund, they score! Klim Kostin, his first goal as a Shark, and it's 3-3.
Riley Smith out muscles. The Sharks gets it up top for Ludwig. He'll shoot, scores! John Ludwig with a seeing eye shot from distance. The Pens go up 4-3. Malkin, here's Ludwig. Joseph fires, scores! Theo Joseph put it to the goal! And the Penguins get some huge insurance. 6 skaters on for San Jose. Bouncing puck away from Granlund. Rust has got it. He's got an empty net. And O'Connor, Rust scores! A 6th spot for Pittsburgh. And Brian Rust salts this one away for San Jose.
We are underway. Thursday night hockey. Dishes into the near corner. The puck sent off the wall. Jackets on the turnover in the slot. Jenner scores! The Jackets 15 seconds in on the Jenner goal. Number 20 on the year. Ahead 1-0.
What a start here for the Blue Jackets.
Good play by Zach Werenski. All set. Here. Good row. Cross ice. Oh! It's redirected. Feeds ahead, down the left wing. Moving in, there's a goal mouth pass, and it's into the net on the redirect.
Claude Giroux finds a goal for Ottawa, and he breaks out of a big slump.
And the Sens have life.
And to Stützle, Quick scores! Tim Stützle wires it home and ties it up for Ottawa.
And this is a response. It wasn't a great start to the third period. Claude Giroux gets him on the board. What a pass through the middle, and then just a quick
five-hole shot by Stützle that's able to beat Merzlikins as he is late to get down on the play.
Less than a minute to go in the power play. And this overtime, Elvis the save, another attempt. Gabranson tried to clear, quick shot there. Oh my, Elvis sprawls across to make the stop. Stützle, another one-timer, Elvis the save there. Outstanding back-to-back saves, and there's the third, and a standing ovation. Everybody getting up on their feet.
No question he made some key saves, but the save of the night goes to Ivan Provorov. He gets his body in front of that puck. Elvis dives across to make sure that bottom is sealed.
0-for-1 this season, but with the score here. Rogeroo, game on the line, slapper, scores! A blast and in from Giroux, and he will love every minute of that shootout dagger against Columbus.
Vegas' deadline deal for Anthony Mantha paid dividends on Thursday as he got on the board with his first goal as a Golden Knight. Highlights after the break.
You know, being here and playing here last week with the team I was a part of for 6 years, it's a unique situation, but you know, I'm excited just to come in here and play this album. I've always had a lot of fun playing here in my past, so looking forward to tonight.
So the Flames power play will get an early opportunity.
And now Sharon Govich in front. Condrey wide open on a big save. Hill point blank. Giovanni has it. Anderson out high with a wrist shot. Blocker save. Hill rebound. Petrangelo, and he chops it out.
Well, a good sign for the Golden Knights is Aiden Hill's sharp here, getting a lot of shots early.
Alex Petrangelo back to the puck. With a long pass to Carlson. Batted in right on goal. Wolf off the play. Dangerously played. Rock came back in the save. Diving back in the stop that chance to Carlson. But it looked like he had a wide open net. After a blunder behind the goal, Dustin Wolf cleans up his own mess.
Chip it behind the net. Mantha swats it the other way. Pahal has it. Gave it to Theodore. In front. Save Wolf on Mantha. Score. Mantha put it in. After the turnover, Wolf dove across, but couldn't get the Mantha chance. That's his first with the Golden Knights to break the ice. Coronado up at him on Giovanni. Condrey to the offensive end, cutting towards the net on save Hill. Marchessault was back on Condrey, but Hill with another big save, his 25th of the night.
Leaves it for Hunt just inside the line. Hunt makes a move, feeds it in front. Sharangovich shutting the shot away, scores! Sharangovich ties it up
at one. Oh, what a nice play.
That goes off Hill's stick. A tough one there.
McNabb over to Theodore. Nice pass. Here's Barbashev. Right in. Stop by one. Big save. Dustin Wolf to keep this tied at one. And the Flames head up ice on the counterattack. Kadri over the line. Kadri shot. That's off the White Cloud line. Kadri back to the front. Dustin Wolf with a 10th Beller at one end, and Coleman, seconds later, puts the Flames on top.
Okay, what a save by Dustin Wolf. That's a goal scorer's goal, and Wolf takes that away with his blocker. Beautiful play, and then the Flames keep winning puck battles. Puck goes in the corner. That's a lot. That's a 50-50 puck. That's a great play.
Around the boards. Matteo, tip back to Theodore in front. Big save by Wolf on the redirection by Carlson. And now Sharangovich. Rolling puck, gets it back and able to bank it out to Hunt with Coronado as they gain the zone. Here's Hunt trying to work through. Coronado scores! You've been talking about his game all night, and it pays off with a goal by Matt Coronado that makes it a two-goal lead.
And it's all started with this great save by Dustin Wolf, and it's all Reed. And then a beautiful right into the wheelhouse of Coronado. Man, you don't draw it up any better than that.
The Golden Knights have struggled since the All-Star break, winning just 6 of their last 16 games since the festivities in Toronto. They are tied for the 6th lowest point percentage in that span and only lead the Wild by 4 points for the final wildcard spot in the West.
A tremendous on-ice ceremony honoring Jordan Eberle for 1,000 games and counting, with the stress on that. Carried along by Mr. 600 tonight, Andrei Burakovsky. Lindgren comes up big. Good shot by Ty Cartier. Andrei Burakovsky tonight. It's game number 600. For the front, McMichael. Ovechkin pulls up. It's blocked. Good play, Tatar. Ovechkin off a stick. Caught by Nygård.
This looks like it's going to come down to a one-mistake game, the way these teams are both playing defensively.
Charlie Lindgren 1-0 on his ledger against Seattle in his career. Nygård on the intercept. Look out! Score! Oshie gets a gift.
This is a big-time mistake and mishandle. He's going to try to fire it up the middle. Doesn't get any lumber on it. TJ Oshie. A power play goal unassisted, and there's the big mistake I just talked about. The Caps off 1-0.
Power play unit number 2 for Dave Hextall. Yamamoto kicked out again by Lindgren. Stretching out completely, a shot and a goal! Cue the maestro! Oliver Bjorkstrand in the right place at the absolute right time. It's a power play goal. The Kraken have tied it.
Sea Monsters are now putting on some pressure. Cough it up. McMichael with a breakaway waltz. McMichael into the backhand. He scores! Connor McMichael!
A beauty on the breakaway for the youngster Connor McMichael. Both teams will have a group meeting at the respective benches. I mean, they have left everything they possibly could on the ice tonight, the guys in white.
Tolvanen lets it fly. Stopped there by Lindgren. The rebound to the corner, and Washington survives and picks up a huge 2-1 win.
Time now for Top Shelf Plays of the Knights.
Cizikas got knocked into by Skinner. Leads to a 2-on-1, and Sorokin got across in the full split on Peyton Krebs.
This might be the save of the year.
To Pastrnak, and Hyman scores! Danton Heinen didn't give up on the play.
For what second effort?
Wolf off the play and dangerously played. Diving back into the crease. Should stop that chance for Carlson. But it looked like he had a wide open net.
Rocheroux. Beam on the line. Slapper. Scores! A blast and in from Giroux. And he will love every minute of that shootout dagger.
Kane's keeping it. Low shot, Orlov. Sam Bobrovsky pitches from an impossible shot angle. Beats Bobrovsky, and it's 2-0 Carolina. Between the Stars and Devils, Wyatt Johnston cuts right down. He shot. He scores.
He dangles through a herd of Devils and rips a shocker past Jake Allen.
Here's Hedman. Across. Point in. And he's gone.
That one should never go in, but Brayton stuck with it, found a way.
Whips it along. Logan Cooley with an opportunity. Brings it in. Logan Cooley scores! A shorthanded goal!
What a goal. What an effort, Logan Cooley. The 19-year-old rookie, and that is speed right there.
Time for our three stars of the night. Our third star is Frederik Andersen, posted a 21-save shutout win over the Panthers. Zach Benson is star number 2, scored twice in the Sabres 4-0 shutout win over the Islanders. And our first star, no surprise, Braden Point, netted 3 goals and 3 assists in the Bolts 6-3 win over the Rangers. And that will do it for us on the fly. From Mike Kelly and our entire crew, I am Keith Irizarry. We will catch you next time.
Military Appreciation Night here. One of these nights where it's a little bit more than just the game.
Oh, what a save by Sorokin! Oshie gets a gift!
Anthony Mantha's first as a Golden Knight.
And then a perfect shot right on the ice. From an impossible shot angle!
What a goal! What an effort!
He is red hot.
Out come the hats! The hottest goal scorer in the NHL strikes again!
Take point!